What a blessing to see everybody gathering together to celebrate our Habib صلى الله عليه وسلم. They asked me to talk about the الشافعي المشفع, our Habib صلى الله عليه وسلم. But we have to know that Sayyidina Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم told us, Allah al-Mu'ti wa ana al-Qasim. Allah is the giver and I distribute. That means everything is given to Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم and he passed it to all of us. And in the same way, Allah told us in the Quran, A'udhu billahi minash shaitanir rajim, Bismillahir rahmanir rahim, Inna a'tainaka al-kawthar. We gave you the kawthar. Some scholars, they say the kawthar is a river in paradise. Some people, they say, is the light of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Some of them say, kawthar kathir. We gave you a lot to give to your ummah. Fasalli rabbika wanhar. Pray to Allah and slaughter. Inna shani'aka huwa al-abtar. The one who hates you is cut. In the Arabic language, the meaning of the opposite meaning, the one that who loves you is connected. We all of us, we want it to be connected. So, our Shafi'a sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, most people, they remember the Day of Judgment and the Shafa'a al-Kubra. But, for us, his Shafa'a started from the moment he was born. The moment he was born, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, all earth fixed. It became from the worst case scenario to khayrul quruni qarni thumma alladhi li thumma alladhi li. Best time ever on earth is my time, time of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and the generation after and generation after. And then he took all the sahaba from the worst case scenario. They worship idols. They do tawaf around Kaaba naked. They do all the bad things to become the best people after prophets. What's he doing, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? He went to a city called Yathrib, changed it to Medina Munawwara. Fixed everything in it. He once came to, there is a boy in Medina that he used to, you know, help in the masjid. He's a Jew. They told Rasulullah that he was sick. Rasulullah went to him, to his house. And he looked at him, he knew that he's dying. And he told him, say, Ashhadu an la Muhammad Rasulullah. Believe in me. He looked at his father. His father is one of the scholars of the Jews. First time, second time, and then his father said, Ati' Abu al-Qasim. His father, his love acted, not his knowledge. He loves his son. He wanted him to be saved. And then he said, Ashhadu an la Muhammad Rasulullah. And he died. Rasulullah said, Alhamdulillah alladhi anqadahu bi. I thank Allah that Allah saved him by me, by Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So we move on. What's his shafa'a sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? Ya Habibi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. In the battle of Hunayn, a shepherd came. The sahaba brought shepherd in the battlefield. They brought him with these sheep. They brought Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Rasulullah looked at him. And he started talking to him, to introduce him to this deen. And he immediately, he became Muslim. He said, Ashhadu anna Muhammadan Rasulullah. He said, Ya Rasulullah, these sheep, they are belong, I take care of them. He said, take some of the soil, throw it on them. They will go back to their owners. This is from the miracles of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And that's what he did, they went. So this Bedouin, this shepherd, you know, he took his sword, he went to fight with Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. In no time, an arrow came to him, on the side of him, and he died. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa took him to his tent. He said, put him in my tent. After they finished, he went to him, and he told the sahaba, he's in paradise, enjoying it. He said, he never did a sajda to Allah. Never did a sajda. And he entered paradise. Look at the shafa'ah. Then move on our time. Allah said, وَإِذْ تَأَذَنَ رَبُّكُمْ لَأَشْرَكْتُمْ لَأَزِيدَنَّكُمْ. Allah said, if you thank me, I'll increase you. If you do hamd, if you thank me, I'll increase you. Who's doing the real hamd? If I say alhamdulillah, thank you Allah, if the real hamd is 100%, I'm maybe gaining 5% of that, 2%, 1%. But in reality, our Shafi'a sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, our action being presented to him. Our action being presented to him. He said, تُعْرَضْ عَلَيْهِ أَعْمَالُكُمْ إِنْ وَجَدْتُ خَيْرًا حَمَدْتُ اللَّهِ. If I find something good, I thank Allah on your behalf. I do hamd. Now his hamd is, will reach 100%. Or maybe 110%, more than 100%. Because why? He's Ahmad, Muhammad, Mahmud. He's the owner of liwa al-hamd. He is the owner of maqam al-hamd, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And he told us, Allah loves hamd. That's why Allah said, alhamdulillah. Hamd is to Allah. Praise to Allah. That's why he gave him this name. So, our action being presented to Allah, wrapped by the hamd of Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And then Allah will look at his habib, hamd. I said, I'll increase it, no doubt. He said, لَإِن شَكَرْتُمْ لَزِيدَنَّكُمْ. And Allah will increase until the day of judgment. So one of you will come with his action and say, whose action is this? Whose prophet is this action? And they will tell him, no, that's your action. But it's increased because of the hamd of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Look at the shafa'ah. Now it comes the real issue that a lot of us will face. If we do something else, that means not a worship, not something good, something bad. Then Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam will do istighfar on our behalf. If I do istighfar, as I said, I can reach 10% of the istighfar of the 100%. When Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam will do his istighfar never be rejected. That's why Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, هذه الأمة أمة مرحومة لا عذاب عليها في الدنيا في الآخرة عذابها في الدنيا. This ummah, this nation is a nation of mercy. There is no punishment on them on the day of judgment. Their punishment in the dunya. بالقتل والفتن والزلازل. By killing each other, you see this everywhere. And the fitan, problems, and earthquake. That's our punishment in the dunya. Now we come to next stage. So during the whole dunya, we're receiving from the Shafi'a sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Now we come to the next stage. When the soul will come out, the Habib sallallahu alayhi wa sallam will take care of us. Because al-Nabiyu awla bil-mu'mina min anfusim. Rasulullah is the one who's guardian, take care of you more than yourself. And then you move to the grave. What happened in the grave? They say, in that grave, if that moment is good, everything after it is good. If it is bad, everything after it is bad. And what will happen? Some people, they say 3 questions. Some people, they 4 questions. Some say 1 question. And it's actually 1 question. What do you say of this man? See, they ask the media answer, Ya Habibi. MashaAllah, he's lucky. I want all of you, inshallah. And that grave, you say, Ya Habibi. Because the Sahaba, they said, مَنْ رَأَوْ بَدِيهَةً هَابَهُ. If you see him a sudden, you have a fear from him. You cannot see anything. And punishment will come. وَمَنْ خَالَطَهُ مَعْرِفَةً أَحَبَّهُ. If you mix yourself by knowing him, you love him. We're sitting here all together to know more about him, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So we love him more and more. So in the grave, his shafa'a, by saying, Ya Habibi, by saying, this is my prophet. Once you say, this is my prophet, that means you already say, La ilaha illallah, you say, this Quran is my book, you say, Islam is my deen, and so you answer all the questions by 1 question. And this is our time for us to know him and to love him and so on. And then on the day of the resurrection, you know, we will be a place where ordered to move to another place and there is a maze. What do I get from Shafa'a of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? They say every believer from previous nations, they have 1 light in their hand. And every prophet, they have 2 lights in their hands. And for us, every believer from this ummah, we have 2 lights. نُورُهُمْ يَسْعَ بَيْنِ أَيْدِيهِمْ وَبَيْمَانِهِمْ. 1 light between their hands and 1 in their right hands. And the Arifin, they say, under each hair of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, there's light. So,
knowing Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم, loving him, doing the durood sharifa, salah on him صلى الله عليه وسلم, then his shafa'ah, what will happen? Allah will apply on you al-mar'u ma' man ahab, if you love him. You will be next to him. Then do you need your light? There's no doubt. And you have the shortest cut to the hawd. And then in the hawd, we'll give you that drink. That nothing will harm you after that. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Now look at the other side. How Allah described for us that day when we move after the resurrection, we go to the yawm al-hisab, the day of judgment. Allah said in the Quran, أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم, يوم لا ينفع مال ولا بنون إلا من أتى الله بقلب سليم. There is nothing will benefit you. Your money, your children, except if you come to Allah, bring to Allah a qalb, a heart that's pure, that's sound, that's salim. Now, I'm intending something on that day. Sayyidina Umar said, Ya Rasulullah, would I have my intellect? After I die, I said, yes. He said, خلاص, I know what to do. So I'm intending in the grave to say, Ya Habibi, Ya Rasulullah. He said, but who would say this message, Ya Habibi? I'm intending, inshallah, on the resurrection, I want to follow that light of Rasulullah sallam. I don't care about anything else. I'm intending on the day of judgment, when Allah said, nothing will benefit you. It's 50,000 years of pain of the sun over the head of all the human being, and they wish to go to the hellfire, just to go away from that pain. My intention, myself. Allah said, nothing will benefit you except you bring a qalb salim. I know my heart. I cannot trust my heart. I cannot trust my heart. I cannot trust the heart of Sidi Mahdi or anybody here. Can I say that any heart here is 100% qalb salim? I don't trust that. I would not take a risk on that day. I want to bring a qalb salim. I want to tell Ya Allah, I brought you a qalb salim. I brought the qalb of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. I brought the qalb of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. I want to be next to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and say, Ya Allah, here is the heart that you are asking to bring. And that day of judgment, which is 50,000 years, where Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told us, all the nations will go from prophet to prophet. All the nations, they go to Sayyidina Adam. They say, nafsi, nafsi. I cannot do anything. Allah is angry. I just so and so. I cannot even say anything. I have a fear of that day. Go to Prophet Nuh. And all prophets say, nafsi, nafsi. I cannot do anything. They go to all prophets. Sayyidina Isa toward the end. They say, go to Ahmad. And they come to Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam and say, ana laha, ana laha. I'm designed for it. Allah designed me for it. Ana laha, ana laha. Now, wallahi, when you hear a hadith for the day of judgment, benefit for yourself. Make intention. I'm intending not to go with all the human being, all the nations going from prophet to prophet to prophet. I'll stick next to Rasulullah sallam because I know they come back to me. They come back to Rasulullah sallam. Because it's going to be 100 years with pain going from prophet to prophet. And all of them, they say, Allah is angry. Allah is angry. Some described this for us. He said, في يومٍ يرغب إلي الخلائق كلهم حتى إبراهيم. He said, the day that all the creation need my shafa, including my father Ibrahim. عليه الصلاة والسلام. So what are we going to do? All of us remember this. After you die, remember this. You will stick next to Rasulullah sallam. One of my shuyukh, rahmatullah alayh, Sheikh Mustafa al-Khan, he's a big scholar, always with his books and so on. But toward the end of, before 1 month before he died, somehow he flipped from, took, left all the knowledge, and he said, I need two things. He said, the first thing I need to know on the day of judgment that Allah is pleased with me. This is my dua. And the second thing, if they gave me choice, if they gave me choice whether I go to paradise or be in the day of judgment next to Rasulullah sallam, I'll choose being next to Rasulullah sallam. And subhanAllah, I took Sayyid al-Habib Ali Jafri to the Sheikh Mustafa al-Khan and he told him the same thing. It was like, he will tell everybody that last few days of his life. So that day, 50,000 years is the biggest mawlid ever. You are celebrating now 1 hour, 2 hours. And see, they also look at our at the time. We have to finish at 10, 11, whatever it is. We try to get more time, but so it's 2-3 hours. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is celebrating his Habib with 50,000 years to show his rank, to show his qadr. Allah told us about himself subhanahu wa ta'ala. He said, ما قدر الله حق قدره. They don't have the qadr of Allah. And the scholar, they say, they don't know the qadr of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Only Allah knew his qadr. And he wanted to show this in the Day of Judgment. That day, we'll be enjoying. All of us. سيدي عماد will say, نحن في روضة. نحن في روضة الرسول الحضور طالبين الرضا وحسن قبولي. We will sing with Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We'll say, يا حبيبي يا رسول الله. We'll say, طلع البدر علينا. And we're waiting for everybody to go and come back. Now what's happened when Allah will tell him, will give him permission. Then he will go to what? He will do sajda. You know, the whole creation, the story of the whole creation between two sajdas. One sajda, shaitan, in order to do it, he didn't do it. He's cursed. And one sajda, Rasulullah will do it to help all the creation, to give him hayat, to give him real life, the endless life. استجيبوا لله ولرسول إذا دعاكم لما يحييكم. Answer Allah and the messenger if he call you for something that give you life. ومن أحيا, whoever give life to one person, it's like give life to all human being. So Rasulullah at that day will do his sajda. And he what? Because he's Muhammad, he's Ahmed, he's in the maqam al-Hamid, he will do Hamid in his sajda, never heard before. And that Hamid will take care of the situation. The anger of Allah will go down. The mercy of Rahmah will go up. And Allah will tell him, Ya Habibi, Ya Habibi, raise your head. Ask anything, I'll give it to you. Do you know what he wants, Rasulullah? He wants every member of you. He will say, Ummati, Ummati. He will not say, Ummi, my mother. He say, Ummati. All of you, he wants all of you. Because he loves all of you. Wallahi, if Allah showed you the love Rasulullah said that loves you all, you'll be surprised. You will have nothing in your heart except loving Rasulullah. And then Allah will give him the shafa' al-uzma that Allah will allow all the nation to go from that under the sun to the courtyard, which is a long story where the shafa'ah and so on, but I'll close with this one, on the sirat, on the bridge over the hellfire, it's been narrated that one person from this ummah, he didn't do something good in his life. He will, you know, try to stand, to walk on the sirat, he will come back down. He cannot stand. He cannot walk. He tried. And then Rasulullah told that one salah on me, he did one durood sharifa on me, the salah will come and take his hand and make him stand and pass the whole sirat until enter paradise. وصلى الله على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم.